Anybody not following anything that DOS says goes. Anybody not following orders from Chike, Dozien, from DOS, you will be removed from IPOB and sanctioned appropriately. You know, before we remove you without knowing where you are. This time around, we will catch you before we remove you. Anything DOS says is what goes. Nzurumike is heading our reconciliation committee. If he calls you on the phone, you must listen to him and do as he says. He is our deputy head of Directorate of State, led by Maazị Chike Dozien. They are the highest decision-making body in IPOB. If that thing is difficult, then I'll refer it to me. Do you understand? Anything they if they call you on the phone, you don't return their call or you're doing strong head, I will then believe that the zoo has brought you over and you'll be dealt with. Edo State, be warned. No dabbling in volunteer affairs or ESN affairs in Edo State. ESN is in Edo State for your information. And very soon work will commence there immensely. Work will commence. Work will Edo State comes under Ikechukwu as Befalam coordinator. We run a discipline movement more than anything. We value discipline more than anything else in the world, in IPOB. That's the only thing we have. That we are able to defeat the zoo and destroy the zoo is hinged on one thing, and that is discipline. If you know you cannot work for IPOB, you get out and join the SABO. One day your judgment will come. We'll find those hiding in Kotonu, those are hiding somewhere near Swamp. In River State, we found out of you. I say River State because it comprises upland and coastal region. We found out of you. They still have a police checkpoint. Okay. Don't worry. You'll hear the news very, very soon. You will hear it. I said, no police checkpoint in Biafra land. I said, no police checkpoint. There was in a bank, go and tell them, I said, no, but if your brother, your uncle, your sister, your cousin is there, tell the idiot to get away and dismantle that checkpoint or else they will die. No state coordinator is allowed to contact the state commander no matter what. And as a commander, if you're removed, you're removed, you step aside, our orders will do the job. We don't want a type of Biafra that will be like the zoo. If you lose election, you rig it and you remain in power. When the age of retirement is 65, at the age of 85, you're still in power. That rubbish will not obtain. We are not like any other stupid sort of black people from Africa. We are Biafrans. You must understand that and follow orders accordingly. My instructions to this global family is this. We have the DOS. We have the finance department. We have the legal department. We have the medical. Anybody who is appointed into office, if you fail to obey your superior officer, you will be dismissed live on air. I will dismiss you myself. And as I said, as I'm dismissing you, men are on the ground to apprehend you. You must obey your superiors. It is based on discipline, please. All this breaking, going forwards and backwards, I want to obey. That means you are not prepared to be in IPOB. If you don't know what obedience is, you shouldn't be here. After all, we are all under oath. It doesn't matter if you were with me from the beginning or not, you must obey your superiors, please. Very, very important. Very, very important. There are also finance officers. You know, those fools that stole our money from Georgia, they think they're very smart. But they will go to jail, and they understand it. If you are a finance officer in the U.S., please, we need all the funds people are contributing. Stop hoarding it. Stop hoarding it, please. When our U.S. finance officer makes contact with you, you must please be able to oblige her and do as you're told. Or if you get a call, it's when you fail. Anytime you get a call from our sister Nene, then you know you're in very serious trouble, you have done something wrong. Please make sure that our accounting and our audit is up to date. I do not understand the reluctance of some individuals in the U.S. to remit the money that people had contributed to ESN. I don't understand the reason why you're holding it. I don't know what for. Please, that was why we left those criminals with money in Georgia and they stole it. Trying to be clever by half, or should I say too clever by half, like the Fulani will always do. The two criminals living in Atlanta, Georgia, hoarded our money. No Kempo and the Zurumba. Two criminals, two rogues from there, stole our money I have all the records, and I must understand that. And I have maintained that any accounts that we have that Nene Nayana cannot see, I do not trust her very account. As long as she doesn't see it, I will not trust it. And very, very soon, I will shut down every account that Nene Nayana cannot see.